that G at my nut lows.
I'm just saying.
They pull up to the scene, they be filled with jealousy. If a bitch get
stop
finicky, she gon' bring the energy. Hit a phone with a C.
3, 2, 1, action.
So hello everyone, it's Salvador and I'm back for another video and I hope you guys are having a good time. Welcome to my channel. Sorry guys that my voice sounds awkward, guys. It's been a long week. You guys know I have a business outside of YouTube, so with that, it's salon life. You have to interact with your guests, so having those 12 hours shifts at the salon with my guests, I've used my voice a lot, especially with the holidays, you know, it was packed. But I'm grateful that I was able to pay my bills. So honey, YouTube ain't paying my bills, so I am sorry, bitches. Let's go. So you guys wanted me to check this out. I'm sorry I've not been here. And also, I'm an empath, so when YouTube is going crazy, I tend to not want to be on YouTube. It's not my fault. As an empath, you guys saw my last video. It's the Asian hate video. So I've been feeling some kind of way, then working on guests at the salon to get away from that feeling. And then we are having people attacking Lil Nas X for his video, which is a masterpiece. You guys go check it out, called Call Me By Your Name. The video is, especially if you're an adult, if you're over 18, because I don't want people coming for me, check it out. It's phenomenal to me. I love the message behind it, is metaphorical, so I'm here for it. So that backlash too affects me as an empath. Then we have the James Charles situation, the cancel culture and all that stuff, so my brain is not. But you guys want me to be here, so let's do this, okay? So in today's video, I'll be checking out Hatton Evangelista said Turning 36 Part 1, the top 10 life lessons I've learned. So I want to see what I've learned so far. Hearts, girl.
It's Hearts, or Love Marie, however you'd like to call me. And welcome back to my channel. As of you who know, I just turned 36, and it is such a blessing. Today, I wanted to share all the things that I've actually went through in life. When I turned 30, I was actually so afraid of getting old, but now as I get older, I realize that, like, you know, aging is such a blessing or a privilege.
It's true.
But of course, aside from all of the other things, getting older is also about becoming wiser. So of course, yes, along with aging, turning 36 comes wisdom, experiences, frustrations, and all of the in-between. So today I am going to be sharing with you the 10 best life lessons I've learned so far. So let us begin.
She's like, so far, people.
Number one would probably be, it's okay to lose some friends.
Yes.
I remember way back in high school and grade school, I used to get bullied so much.
I
so
know
I
that
always
feeling.
Had this yearning, or I wish that
one
I
in
had
friends.
Some friends. Yeah. I always would change myself to belong.
Yep.
People that accepted me.
I
and
know that feeling.
I eventually joined showbiz. And, you know, there are a lot of people that I've met, of course, along the way that were very, very kind. I remember having friends, and I was never again, I also mentioned this in one of my interviews, I was never again the queen bee. In fact, I think it's because I want to have friends so much that I'm so conscious that I don't want to be the center of attention. I just
right, you let them shine so that way you don't lose them.
I would get frustrated because I thought that since we worked together, we were taping Friends, that it would last longer. This is when I was like 16, and I was still so young. So I would really, really cry a river whenever I feel that. Nah,
it's true, with age is just, I have a little friends and I'm,
because,
I don't
you know,
even want anymore.
It's just a vicious cycle in showbiz. You meet people and
yeah,
then chika-chika lang, and that's when I realized, okay, this is just PR, or it's just socials. So not necessarily that you'll meet your lifetime friend in your workplace or all of that, and that's okay. Because
you're right.
In a way, when I look back, yeah, there are some things that were done that was painful, but then I don't think that they meant it also. Hindi lang kayo bagay, and that's okay too. So as you go through life, you do meet people that come and go, some will stay.
Yeah,
and at the end of the day, I think it's all about having a core group. You don't have to be
just two friends, yeah,
lots of friends for people,
and they're my family too, so
or you have credibility.
They're more of a family to me than my actual
blood family. I don't think people should always say na, ah, malami siyang kaibigan, kaya mabait siya. No, it's not always like that. It's important lang that you have your core. Can be two people,
yes.
Can be your family, and then plus one good friend. That's just it. Now, if you're blessed with a lot of friends, well, good for you. As long as you're a good person.
I love it. And you don't try to please people at all.
And just think it as character development and growth. And don't worry, because you'll always find someone that will be there for you, whether you're down, which is the easiest, by the way. I just want to inject that. It's easier to be friends with someone that's down. It's usually when you're up there or you're successful that it gets lonely. So, may dadating at may dadating. So, don't feel bad. And doesn't mean you're a bad person if you lost a person or a friend. No, it's not like that. It's actually okay to outgrow people. That's just really part of
life. So true.
Okay, so the next would be, which is so important, you have to be with someone who doesn't hold you back or allows you to grow. I have like a track record. Although I saw this video on YouTube, that is such a lie. And hindi ko na kadami boyfriend ko, but I did date a lot of guys and I'm fine. I'm glad I did. I've met so many people. I had a boyfriend that was so bad to me. He wasn't showbiz. I hardly talked about him or spoke about him. Sad to say, he was actually just a rebound. Just kidding. But I really wanted to work because I wanted to get over someone. But he was really cruel. I remember for how many years after, I couldn't go to a certain area in Manila because I was so traumatized.
That you would run into.
My mom was in charge of my money then, but he would tell me that, you know, if we do end up together, you can't touch your money until you die, only your kids can ganyan. You have to live a simple life, blah 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 blah. Aside from that, was fine. Okay lang yun. The idea of working wasn't really in the cards. You're too revealing. It's not ladylike. Yung mga ganyan. Such a turn off.
Yeah.
You have to be with somebody who will allow you to experiment.
Yes.
But getting to know yourself even more. You know, even if I'm 36, I'm still getting to know myself.
So true.
I'm still discovering so many things about myself. And you have to be with somebody who's on the same page. Or else you're stuck. You're not gonna grow. I really believe in we are equals. Of course, I look at Chase and I respect him and his decisions because he is the man of the house, but he allows me to say
to
what
do
I want.
You.
He allows me to wear what I want. He allows me to work and he inspires me to do that.
Wow.
And because he's like that to me, I'm a happy person. Happy wife, happy life. I think it's really, really important that before you settle and get married, you really need to get to know the person. Don't rush. Once you're married, you're married. If you feel like it's not time, it's all right. There's no judgment. You want to break up and see the world, do what you need to do, because at the end of the day, you gotta end up with somebody that's not gonna control you, that's gonna make you bloom as a person.
That'll make you happy being alive.
Wonderful to share a life with someone like that. Okay, so number three, it's really okay to not be okay and to ask for help and actually forgive yourself for feeling a certain way or being a certain way. You know, I spoke about mental illness and depression and anxiety, and not a lot of people actually know that I went through something so bad. I mean, it probably doesn't seem bad because, you know, I'm wearing this nice Chanel jacket.
The
but
jacket
these things don't
gorgeous.
Matter if you're not happy or if you're going through something in your mind. Really, honestly, when I went through something, I thought my accessories, my bags would give me a purpose to live. I didn't know how I got into that black hole. And I remember of thinking of the worst things. Like, I felt I was left with no choice but to kind of end things. It was really that bad. Now I can talk about it. I'm so glad that I'm out of it. It's because I wasn't ashamed. I'm very open. I really talk to people. It's just a matter of making sure that you talk to the right people. And I saw a doctor.
Because sometimes if you don't,
took certain meds for that time. And I'm not ashamed to say that because I'm in a better place now, and I'm so glad that I did that, because
Guys,
why would I waste life? Why would I waste opportunities and
right.
And why would I do that to the people who love me?
You always want to be around people that will help you grow better.
I have
not
so much love in my heart. Why would I waste that? So if you're going through something, don't be ashamed. I remember feeling like a lemon, like a reject in a factory, that what's wrong with me? But no, it's actually okay not to be okay. It's okay not to be
adulting
perfect. It's normal that you're not perfect. And everybody needs a little guidance from time to time.
So true.
If you're going through something really, really bad,
it's crazy how you outgrow a lot of stuff the older you get.
And if that person isn't giving you the right advice, talk to somebody else. Just keep talking to people, and you will find that person that will direct you and say, okay, you know, itong gagawin natin, you will do ito, you're doing yan. Ayusin natin to, kayan mo yan. That's just how simple it is. And believe me, you will get over it. But the moment that you keep stalling, it's just gonna carry on, and it's just gonna make you weaker. And your immunity to this load you're carrying, it won't last very long, because I was almost there. But yes, talk to someone. That's the first step. And also, I wanted to add that we're so lucky that people are actually talking about this so openly.
I know, before it's like a taboo.
And imagine way back, Pab, if you talk about it, ay, baliw, may lahi na baliw, ganyan, or huwag ka na mag-anak, baliw ka, ganyan, ganyan, or reject ka, ganyan. They were already typecasted, but now it's alright to talk about it. And even if you have conservative families or parents, talk to a friend. Sometimes you have to
tell me about it
on your own, because you need to survive. And really, when it comes to mental health, you cannot draw strength from someone. You have to work on yourself. Yourself is the only one that's
so true.
Yeah, talk to someone. The next one would be allowing yourself to be happy and do what you want, and not be afraid of slowing down to put yourself first when it comes to like work or leisure or shopping.
I love this video because
I'm very, very guilty of this because
of the way
I'm such a workaholic. And sometimes when I just skip one day and I rest, the next day my requirements doubles. So it's very, very hard. It just really makes a huge difference when you take a step back and you just chill, nap, watch Netflix, do what you want, eat
and it's
what you
okay,
want.
You don't have to feel guilty.
And the next day, magically, you have a different outlook and a different energy, and you're more happy to do work, which is always hard, but it's just different. It makes such a huge difference. And also, you have to prioritize again yourself. You have to make yourself happy in order to work,
able
in
to
order
even
to
help
sacrifice
for
things
others,
for
right.
other people. It's not always about me, 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 me. No, it's about, yes, it's about you, but you need to make sure that you're in a good place so you can give yourself away a little bit to share with people. So when it comes to your kids or your family, hindi naman pwedeng sacrifice all the way. I appreciate that from people, and it's really like bow down. But I think it's important for ladies or mothers out there, you know, even if it's hard. I mean, I've seen it. I mean, of course, people say, oh, wala ka naman anak. But it's not even about that. I've seen it firsthand. I also have kids here at home. Kahit konting time para sa sarili mo is very, very important and will go a long way. And I think it's also important that the people around you see that you never neglect yourself, because you also want them to grow up with self-worth. So I think it's very important.
That's why.
Another, since we do live in a world of social media, it can be great or it can be vicious and ugly.
Yikes.
It's just really a matter of how you see it. So I remember before, when I used to get bashed a lot a couple of years ago, and I would be bashed every day for years. Everything I did, I was just bashed. I couldn't get it. And I'm so glad that I didn't have my anxiety at the time, because, oh my God, can you imagine? I remember she's telling me, eh, de quit. Di mo kaya, di quit. Stop posting. You put yourself out there, be open to what people are going to say. If you put yourself out there because you want to be seen, then live with it. But if you put yourself out there because you're happy with what you're doing and you just want to share your pictures, then don't look at the bad side. Look at the people that you want to make happy. People pleaser.
It's true.
And it's not that it matters to
just
me,
that sometimes
I like to dress up, I like to put makeup, I like to, you know, have my vlogs.
You may give so much.
I want to entertain people. I want them to be happy.
It doesn't stop,
I want to
and then
people.
You become
now,
frustrated.
Now, somebody says something bad. Of course, sometimes when
it's time to take
I worked
step back
a day that day and I was
and
really
recharge.
Tired and my immune system was down, I was weak, pinatulan ko. I have my moments, but 98% of the time, I'm happy. And I feel social media, yes, it can be bad, there are pros and cons, but it is such a beautiful platform that is, I feel, amazing for so many people, big or small. It's a platform that you can use to inspire, to be inspired, to help, to meet people, and to see.
And that's what I love
that
about social media. I want social media to be, to inspire people and stuff like that.
So try to work on it. So next would be consistency is key. When I look back at myself before, although I tried to change, I tried to become bohemian, I tried to change again, yeah, but at the end of the day, this is really who I am, and I've always been consistent. I would fight for who I am. Of course, I'd falter at times because I wanted somebody to love me for what they wanted me to be, but this is who I am, and now that I feel that I celebrate myself as who I am,
it's
so liberated and confident.
Yep.
Even when I decide about something, I know what I want, and I don't falter or I don't adjust because
to make others feel right.
No,
yes,
I love myself already for who I am because she struggled a lot in the past.
It's true, though.
So also, consistency is key.
Maturity,
when it comes to, aside from your
it's
individuality,
amazing.
When it comes to your health, you know, you can't expect to be healthy if you're really messing up your body. I remember before when I was younger, I used to take diet pills and it really messed up my system.
That's
I remember
so
before I would become sickly or nahihimatay-himatay ako kasi my diet was so messed up. What I learned as I got older and
it's
mature,
like you get comfortable in your own skin.
You really have to work out. There is no shortcut. Or if you don't work out, 80% of what you put in your mouth will dictate the body you have. And I know we
yep.
don't have Whole Foods groceries all the time, but it's really making the
so
better
true.
Choice. Being healthy, staying fit, gives you a longer life, gives you more time to have, you know,
and it helps with your,
Another thing a lot of people ask me
so the way you
about my skin,
go into
about
situations.
Age, I'm 36, and I've always been consistent. I'm glad that I had a mom that would, you know, nag me about my skin and pamatulog ka dapat ganon para hindi na ka ganon. So you have to be very consistent if that is something that you want to take care of. You have to really start early. Hindi yung today ko lang naisipan, but it's never too late as well. Being a Ponds girl also, because talking about skin and all of that, I've been with them for a really long time. And I remember at that time, I was still very young, wild, and free. I think I was already with Cheese then. I was very tanned. I love the beach. Although I would always moisturize because my mom would tell me, moisturize.
Well, yeah, she was tanned.
I wasn't so much of a sunblock girl. And so I remember I needed something to cover up or have coverage and then have SPF, and I became the BB girl. And I remember how I got that was I was in El Nido and I was talking about how obsessed I was with Pond's BB cream, and I didn't know that the boss of Pond's was right beside me, and she was like, so yeah, that's how I got it. I remember getting the call that I was officially a Pond's girl. It came shortly after my El Nido trip, and I was just, what? And at that time, I remember, I was all right. You know, like, I was never really the type to be super famous. I was like, Pond's? And so, I was very, very happy because they're such a good brand. And I've always been
I've seen that face.
My
oh,
mom
wait, that was Hatem Evangelist.
All over her neck and arms. And
I saw that
and
picture in
so
Malaysia.
I grew up with Pond's. So I was
when
very,
I was in college.
I just remember
it
was a...
What the...
Or like that. I remember that. It was for the Pond's BB cream. And it was me looking in the mirror, and the girl in the mirror had longer hair, and the girl looking in the mirror was wearing a ponytail. It was both me, but I remember that because I was just so nervous, but also happy because they were gonna give me a lot of Pond's BB cream. Especially, that's why you have to endorse something that you sincerely, genuinely love, because everything's gonna turn out natural, and you could ad-lib and talk about your experience and know what you're talking about. So I love shooting stuff like that for Pond's. I also saw a video. It was That's the Pond's Promise. It was nice because it was very
emotional. She looks so different there.
The music that they also used in that video, and it was talking about my sacrifices. But yeah, that was nice. Every time I shoot for Pond's, it's always an experience because Pond's is such a huge brand, a trusted brand, super credible.
Yeah.
And that's why it's nice to kind of grow with them, age with them, that they're there every step of the way, each chapter of my life. So whenever I do something for Pond's, there's just so much history and so much for me to share.
Yeah,
so
you're,
with them for a long
it's
time.
Like you're
just who
following
I am
a legacy, you're joining a legacy.
Balidosa. And I really believe if you spend time to take care of something, it'll get better. And if
so
you
true.
Invest your time and efforts into something, something
consistency
good
is key. She
I would
said
always
it.
Take care of my skin. When I was younger, not as much. But I remember when I turned 25, I started to really care
right.
more. And it's all about prevention. again, when you talk
yeah,
about
25 is like a turning point in everyone's
when
life.
When you talk about aging, when you talk about skincare, it's like looking at the map of her life. Like her face is the map of her life. You try to take care of not have wrinkles and all of that. It's about aging gracefully. And again, like what I said a while ago, to be part of a brand for a long time.
Yes, no drinking, no smoking. Sunscreen, moisturizing, drinking plenty of water, supplements, vitamins, eating healthy, exercising,
sleeping on your back,
not on your face.
It's just wonderful. I celebrate aging.
And moisturize.
I celebrate it with grace. Oh my God, I am such a people pleaser, like what I said.
I know.
But you cannot keep worrying about pleasing somebody or not pleasing them. Sometimes we put so much energy.
Now I just walk away. I don't even try to even explain myself.
But honestly, they're probably not even thinking about you. Although this is the hardest for me, because I really do care a lot about na-offend ko ba siya, or was I not too friendly, or hindi niya nakita yung smile ko kasi nakamasok ko, baka isipin niya.
That's what happens when you're a sweet person.
And that really consumes me. I remember I was talking to my driver, right, and we were on our way to Sorsogon. It's a really dangerous ride, so you go through the bitukan ng manok. It's like an area. And I remember telling him, it's alright, kahit mag 10 hours tayo, wag na natin gawing 7, basta safe tayo. And I remember, I woke up because they were really speeding, like that, and then they would take over. And one time, he pressed the brakes kasi nung nag-take over siya, may dumating na truck, binalik niya. I'm still struggling how to make pagsabihin someone, huwag mo na kasing pilitin, yung ganyan. So, kuya, pwede yung huwag masyadong mabilis. Tapos, hindi, kundi nakatulog natin. So, tapos,
oh my gosh.
Sige, kuya, huwag masyadong mabilis. Baka mabangga tayo. Gumanon ako. You know, just saying that, when I raised my voice like that, exactly like that, hindi na ako makatulog.
Right, you feel bad, like, yeah.
Baka na-offend ko siya. Baka feeling bad siya. Mabangga kami. Going back to what I'm saying, lessons in life, don't so much.
It's
basta
true.
Wala ka namang ginawang.
Even when I get out of the car, I know I do it gently, yeah.
Give him a last touch, like, okay yun, or something, then go. But stop worrying about people so much. Minsan nasa kanila lang kung gusto kanila o hindi. Minsan kasi kung try ka na try, hindi ka na gusto, kawawa ka naman. Minsan kung nag-try ka pero not enough, hindi ka na gusto, nasa kanila na yun. Minsan di ka na talaga nila gusto, in short, kahit mabait ka. As long as you know you're a good person,
oh, wow, this video is really good.
Try hard. It works. At least it's 86% of the time. Still
that's
makes a big
right.
difference instead of thinking about it so much. Family is really everything at the end of the day. I've gone through so much with my family. Looking back, of course, I had my angry moments, I was rebellious, but I never really thought that they were bad. Because even if I don't agree up to this day with some things, there's some things that they did, they love me. And they have a different way of showing it. And that's why I'll always be there for my family. Family really comes first. Kasi sila yung nandun nung hindi kasikat. Sila yung nandun pag wala kang pera. Sana lahat na magkamag-anak. Kung kailangan na kailangan mo, mungutang nandun sila
that's
pa rin yun.
True.
Without interest. And everybody else will fade. Family is really, at the end of the day, very, very important. And I think no matter what happens in the outside world when it comes to your work or your relationships, what's important is you always have a home that you can go to at the end of the day. That is such a blessing. Like me, my sister Camille, para kami aso pusa, and we were actually known in the family na grabe magawa yan, ganyan. But, you know, at a certain age, we understood each other. It fits like a glove. And so I really, really treasure my sister. In fact, when I'm very, very old, mas matanda si Chi, so I'm not gonna remarry. And I told my sister, tayong dalawa na lang magsasama. Tayong dalawa. So yeah, family is everything. Don't forget your dogs too. Another one is you must love yourself first. You cannot give what you don't have. So in a relationship,
so true.
Back to being married or being with anybody, if you don't put yourself first, how can you take care of other people?
Right.
If your love tank for yourself is full, even if the love tank or what their language of love they give you, you don't have to demand so much from everyone around you if you're actually okay on your own.
Yeah.
And I feel if you're like
it should be exhausting too.
Better. Because sometimes it's draining to be with someone.
What did I say?
You're not gonna toy, you're not ganyan, chuchu. You can't expect so much from people. That's the sad thing. It has nothing to do if they're bad, ah. Because some people say, ah, kasi ganito siya, hindi siya okay na boyfriend. Sometimes, okay naman siya eh. Mabait siya. You guys are good friends, diba? As a boyfriend and girlfriend. But it means that some people can try to drain the life out of you because sila
tell me about it. Oh, honey.
And so I feel that you have to be complete. You have to love yourself first.
She's right.
When you love someone, you can't have expectations so much from that person. If they give, wow, let's get married.
Right.
You know, but if they don't and they're actually a good person,
okay.
Chill, diba? So put yourself first. It'll change a lot of things. Perspective is key. So changing your perspective changes everything. Sometimes when you're such a worrywart, like I'm such a worrywart.
Right.
I remember a friend was asking me, let's go on the yacht. We're going to sleep over. It turned out to be one of the best trips, but I missed it because I was too afraid that, oh my God, magkakapsizing yacht.
I know.
Unexpected storm.
Especially when it comes to investments for me. I'm like, I was so scared. Then I'm like,
I also, because grew up very sheltered, so I have so many fears. Just going to the toilet in Paris, baka matigan ka. Diba? So mga ganyan. It's not that you're not careful, but you have to change the way you look at things. For example, with work, you keep complaining. Parang mahal ko naman tanong umbisa, pero ngayon nakakabwisit, nakaka-anxiety na. Stop complaining because at the end of the day, mahirap talaga kumita ng pera. And at the end of the day, it's work. So know the difference of work and pleasure. So yeah, that's a big difference. So when you're working, okay, I'm gonna be cerebral. I'm gonna work. And then I'm so tired, I'm so inis, but it's okay. Kikita ko ng pera dito. And then after that, uwi, have red wine. Diba? Watch Netflix. Get popcorn.
Like today's meant to be the day out. Diba? I'm meant to just sleep in all
so,
day.
So iba yun.
From a long week.
Because if you have a perspective na ano ba to, hindi ako masaya, parang hindi to para sa akin, kailangan ko hanapin yung kailangan ko gusto, chuchu, ang bigat-bigat. Then, yung ilang hours mo naging times 10. So, you're more miserable. Iba talaga when you look at
it's true!
You'll be a bit more positive.
Guys, what she says makes a lot of sense. Oh my God, my voice, I can
not
hear it. It sounds so weird.
I'm imposing false positivity to you guys. I get it. I get that working is harder. I get certain situations are hard. People, okay, say, oh, hindi naman yun naranasan. I have my moments and my trash level of pain is different from yours. May ibang cruise na dinadala natin. Just wanna put out
guys
there.
Headache?
It just helps a lot. Pag hindi ka masyadong negative with what you're doing.
Right.
Because negative na yung ginagawa mo, negative
ka pa sa
talaga yan. Lighten it up a bit by looking at it differently. There are always two sides of the story. There's always two perspectives. It's either you be negative or you be positive. Dito na tayo sa positive. Para pag nilagay mo yung positive sa negative, it
cancels out.
You get what I'm saying? Yeah, so that was very light. It was still fun, a little heavy, light, whatever. But I enjoyed it and I hope you guys learned a few things from my life lessons.
Guys, my
There's so much
sexy.
Actually that I want to share. Maybe a more unfiltered version of this eventually. But for now, that's it, Pansit. This has been Heart. I will see you again. Bye.
How, this is why I love her videos because... Guys, when you're a matured person, you want matured stuff, so it's she's right. You get to a point which when you're matured, something's like if it's not something inspiring or something that is educational or something that intrigues you or keep you excited, you're like, you know, you no longer just jump into it and say, oh, let me, you know, you're like, you don't even follow the trends, you know, you look at them like, what are you guys doing? You just do you. Wow. Okay, Hearts. I'll see you guys soon in the next video. I'm sorry my voice is... My voice is not having fun today. Let's be real. But sorry, guys. I'm okay. Just... I think I'm drained. This is what happens when you're a stylist. Because it's... You're using all your body to work. So I love doing it, but... I know the effect it does to the body. So anyone who tells me that being a stylist is easy, I don't think you've been a stylist yet. Yeah. I'll see you guys soon in the next video. Bye guys. Oh, today I'm gonna sleep well. 'Cause I'm loving myself
real good. Did you guys hear that? I'm scared.